Family can denote different meaning to different people, evoke varied feelings as for us Indians it's a motley crew of people working towards a singular goal of improving their livelihood.
Motley crew, here are we!
Not that motley crew. A clan that gives you protection in this cruel world and is a big part of your identity. Given it being such a big part of everyone's real life, how can the content world stay away from it? But fear not, I went through a whole year of TV shows and found out which ones could be the best for your viewing pleasure. Here are the top 5 family-focused TV series of 2010s. Schitt's Creek. For the Indian viewers, it is going to be like sipping wine on the beaches of Maldives or Sri Lanka. Oh, who am I kidding? I have no clue where normal people go to forget about their worries. Wait, did I say normal people? I meant people. Just people. If only I could ask these ladies for their opinions on my travel plans.
We go somewhere where it's cold and you get wine.
No.
Okay, bye. Bye.
Coming back to the point, this guy created a show with his real and real life son about a wealthy dysfunctional family consisting the parents and two spoiled kids who lose their fortune after being defrauded by their business manager. This feel-good show with its extravagant characters and some great progressive and to-the-point storytelling is what Indian audience could find relatable. Also, Catherine O'Hara, the actress who played the mother in the first two Home Alone movies, is also the mother in this series. What else do you need, my friend? The closest Indian series I could relate to Schitt's Creek was maybe Sara Bhai vs. Sara Bhai. Mind you, both are very different shows, but the relatability of a dysfunctional family who try hard to overcome their episodical problem by the end of half an hour is very similar. Schitt's Creek has in total 6 seasons, each one of which you can catch on Netflix.
My bebe girl leaving me so soon.
Ye meri family. TVF has put out stellar content over the past few years, establishing an audience filled with nerds who cream their pants to the thought of a new TVF series starring Jeetu Bhaiya. By the way, kids, by creaming the pants, I mean that a person got some cream on his pants from a cake, which was there because it was his birthday, and he got it on his pants. Awkward. Ye Meri Family has Mona Singh. Jassi Jassi, koi nahi. Playing the mother of the 12-year-old protagonist played by the brilliant Vishesh Bansal, who reminds me of, well, me when I was 12. This show had me taking a trip down the memory lane with each character reminding me of members of my own family. Her protagonist's minuscule problems are what probably every teenager in the Cartoon Network era felt like having. If you were a young kid who, while growing up, fought with your siblings over the handling of the first player remote control, then this is specially for you. This TV show will remind you of the simpler times of prime Maggie parties and also the times when one of the legends of the game of cricket cross-dressed and was called Jam Jam Jammy.
No jam for Jammy!
Auntie, can I have some jam?
Animal Kingdom. While the rest of the shows are feel-good comedies, Animal Kingdom is anything but that. This another underappreciated American series is actually based on an Australian movie, which won many plaudits from the critics. Personally, I feel that the series finds its footing as the episodes go on, but it's a thrilling watch nonetheless. If the adrenaline-fueled action scenes don't thrill you, watch this twisted series for the beautiful acting on display, especially by Miss Ellen Barkin, who can excite and make you piss your pants at the same time. Please don't quote me on that. Animal Kingdom is available on Netflix for Indian audiences, but fair warning, this show contains people using drugs and being naked. If there was any confusion before, the list name is Family Focus Shows, not shows you can watch with your family.
God is watching your decision.
Metro Park. This little gem of a show focuses on the Patel family and their loved ones trying to find the right balance between them trying to follow their Indian culture and also them living and improving their lives in the US of America. America, yeah, coming again to save the motherfucking day, yeah. Ranveer Shore shines as always with great cast around him, playing the characteristically simple yet over-the-top middle-class Indian working hard to feed himself and his family.
Oh yeah, this is new phone. No, I'm just doing the rectum scan.
Uthale re baba, uthale.
Metro Park has only 9 episodes, the first of which you can stream on YouTube for free, while the remaining 8 you can get on Eros Now app. Kim's Convenience. Another show I recently binge-watched was this Canadian show which focuses on a Korean-Canadian family with last name Kim, which runs a convenience store. Convenient enough for you? The more I watch any content focusing on any other Asian countries, I swear I get even more convinced that all Asian parents, yes, that includes Indians, have the same idiosyncrasies. Having the emotional maturity of a teenager, parents have a difficult time conveying their love to their children because they never received it themselves, and that same love could come out in ways that could disrupt the dynamics of the family. Sorry for going all dire on you, but that's not really the tone of the series. Don't get me wrong, this playtime series do explore all the emotional baggage that comes with holding a family together, but it's still a fun and easy watch which you can do while having your dinner. Dinner. Binge man hungry. The show is available on Netflix for Indian viewers, which stars future Marvel star Simu Liu in Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings, and will feature the real Mandarin, not an actor, playing an actor, playing a villain. I could have included shows like Good Luck, but didn't want to include another TVF series just to keep it interesting. You can go off on the comments as to what you think of these shows and what would you have put instead. Like, share and subscribe for good measure so that you get to know every time I put on a new video. This is your friendly neighborhood Benjman, and you stay classy, people.